First off, you know, today is really, we're not going to be announcing a lot of details today. Today is more about just telling all of you about the concept of what we're doing and really getting the opportunity for you to meet us and learn about who we are and why we're here in Phoenix and what we're going to be doing. You know, in the coming weeks, there will be a lot more information and more of the details coming out. First off, who here has been to a Superfly event before? Anybody? Okay. Nice. Great. Well, for those of you who haven't and are not familiar with us, let me tell you a little bit about Superfly. In the last 20 years, we have really become the leading independent producer of festival experiences in the country. One of our foundational properties is a property called Bonnaroo. It's a festival that happens in Tennessee. It's really become iconic worldwide. It's a multi-format, multi-stage experience. We have really some of the best in talent across music and comedy and arts every year that comes there. We also are the creators and operators of the Outside Lands Music Festival that happens in San Francisco's Golden Gate Park. And that's probably a little bit more of an analogous thing to what we're going to be doing here. It's a city festival that's really representative of all the things that are culturally significant and valuable within the Bay Area. We also just recently announced a new festival, a comedy event, also in the Bay Area called Colossal Clusterfest. that is a partnership with Comedy Central, that's featuring Jerry Seinfeld and Kevin Hart, and it's going to be another fantastic event. The mission of our company is really to bring people together through connection and create joy. We do this through these experiences that bring people together, that are these shared moments, and that really help express community and culture through a live experience. And that's really what we're here to do for the Phoenix market. We're here to bring something that will be representative and inclusive of the community. One of the things that we're very innovative with and is one of our hallmarks is we're very focused on both the operational and creative details. You know, we take great strides to make sure that the fan experience is first, and that we're always thinking from a perspective of how this is serving the artistic community and the general community at large. So that's what we're here to announce today, which is the Lost Lake, what we're calling the Lost Lake Festival. And it's going to be held here at Steele Indian Park, October 20th through 22nd. And it is going to be a multi-stage, multi-format event. So, you know, we're really excited to be doing this here at Steele Indian Park, School Park. It is just, you know, we go all over the country and world looking at sites and locations to do events like this. And this park here is one of the best that we have really seen. It's gorgeous. It's got lots of different programming opportunities. It's really, we feel, going to be an amazing opportunity here. And I wanted to hand it over to Laura for a minute just to talk about the park and, you know, the community around it, because we just think it's such an amazing opportunity here. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm Rick Farman. It's F-A-R-M-A-N, and I'm one of the co-founders of Superfly.
Hello, welcome to the heart of the city. You are sitting in this fabulous environment with great restaurants, arts district, the diversity, the cultural diversity that is embedded within this area. But more importantly, welcome to our native beginnings. If you know the history of this area, we had the Phoenix Indian School band that dates back to the beginning of Arizona. And they played from that beginning to we're hoping to see if we can get some of the members or some of the family members together to be able to play at Lost Lake. It's a perfect branding, Lost Lake, because we have such deep history here that we don't know about. And that history we're going to be able to tell through Lost Lake festivals and many different venues. And what I love about it is that it's connectivity. It's bringing many different people of diverse backgrounds and cultures together to be able then to tell their story and how they connect and how they embed with one, how they connect with one another, but also be able then to tell their unique story through music and through entertainment. And so I think this is a great opportunity for us. It's in the heart. And as I always leave with my District 4 tagline is, we're rocking District 4, so it's gonna be rocking those days in District 4. And I hope everyone enjoys it and all the neighborhoods also participate. Thank you.
So this is the general location that we're gonna be using. If you're not familiar with it, you can also come up here afterwards and take a look and I can show you around. We don't have the specifics on here yet because we're still working through, some of the finer details of where everything's going to be located. But the big open fields there down in the left-hand corner are going to be where a majority of the stages and activities are happening. But we're going to really activate and utilize the entire park. And the experience here is going to be, as I said, multi-format. There are a lot of different things beyond what you see at a music festival per se. Now, music will be a core of this festival. We're going to have 40 plus artists. It's going to be a real mix of the moment, acts and up and coming acts, as well as some iconic artists as well. So it'll be diverse in terms of the genres, spanning a lot of different things that are really resonating with music fans currently. The culinary part is going to be huge because we have experienced firsthand that Phoenix has an amazing culinary scene. The depthness of the different food offerings, the different cocktail and drink offerings, beer, even wine, is all really a part of this region and community. And so we really are going to be inviting the local makers of those products to come out and participate in this event. That'll be a big facet of what we're doing. The other thing that we typically do with food and drink experiences is customize certain things around a particular concept or a particular type of cuisine. So we have a thing called cocktail magic, for instance, where we mix magicians and cocktails for sort of a unique cocktail party experience. We have a thing called Hamageddon that we do at one of our events, where we bring all sorts of different barbecue vendors around what we call Henry, what is a massive, 30, 40 foot pig that we roast a real pig in the middle of. Now, I'm not saying we're doing those specific things here, but just to give you some color of the type of experiences that we're looking to bring here. It's not just food booths. It's really deeper than that. We're going to be integrating the food and the makers right into the experience programming that we're doing. Games is another really big element that we feel is going to help express everything that this area has to offer. Phoenix and this area is a sporting town. You guys support your sports teams. People are very active here. There's a really active lifestyle. And we feel like that is a real opportunity for us to bring that into a festival environment. And then art, we've coming from the outside here again, have been so impressed by the breadth and diversity and level of the different art that is existing here in this community. We've already sourced a lot of really exciting artists to participate with us. And we're really going to be going through all the whole region to find who are the best artists to bring into this event. So, why Phoenix? Why are we here? I think that we have all really felt that there's something special happening right now in this city and in this region. Obviously, it's a large city, and there's been tremendous growth, particularly in the downtown and core part of the city. A lot of people are, a lot of energy is coming back here, a lot of new businesses are starting here, and you know, we can just feel that there's that palpable energy where an event like this can hopefully help and further take that to another level. And so we think it's really ripe in that way. So I want to also, you know, hand it off to Mayor Stanton to really talk about kind of that and a little bit more of why this makes sense for this market.
Rick, it's great to be here, and I'm glad that Superfly has made this big decision. You're taking a chance on us, we're taking a chance on you, and I can't wait for us to partner together to make sure that Lost Lake Festival is super successful in year one and for decades to come. So Councilwoman Pastor, Vice Mayor Pastor, myself, and the entire city look forward to working with you. You asked the question, why Phoenix? Well, it's about time. That's my attitude. I mean, people are voting with their feet to come to our city. We're the fastest growing big city in the United States of America with an incredibly beautiful, diverse population. We're reinventing ourselves in real time in terms of reinventing our economy and to be a more innovative economy, a more export-based economy. We're such an exciting time with our arts and music scene. Charlie Levy's here and others who have just helped us take it to a whole new level, and this is going to help us to get on the map nationally and internationally as a great live music location that celebrates our musicians. Obviously, from an arts opportunity, I mean, you know, people were concerned about whether a great artist could make a living here. Man, that's gone away. It's happening here in Phoenix. The rest of the country and the world has discovered us, and it's the right time for a music, culinary, arts, and games festival of this magnitude and size. We're ready for it. And when I say we're ready for it, I mean our city, the market is ready for it, and the city itself is ready for it. Probably a few years ago, we wouldn't have had the innovative leaders inside the city to keep an open mind to do something like this in the heart of our city of this size and magnitude, tens of thousands of people each day over a three-day time period. We probably would have said, nah, maybe not, it's going to be difficult, it may be challenging with neighborhoods, etc. You got a great leader who represents this area in Vice Mayor Pastor. I'm all in, and you've got our professional city staff who's all in to make sure that this this opportunity, this festival, Lost Lake, is going to be a massive success. So we're glad that you saw that same vision that we've seen in ourselves, and we're ready for this.
Well, thanks so much for that, and we're so excited to be working with y'all. We felt so welcome here by so many different people in the community, certainly the mayor, the councilwoman, vice mayor, but you know, so many others as well. And I just want to mention a few in DPI, Dave Kreider and Kathleen, and Paul Blue from the city manager's office have been incredibly supportive. You know, these things are difficult to do. You need to work as a team. You need to be engaged with solving the problems that arise from them. And we really believe that we've got the right environment here to make something extremely successful. So a big part of this as well is our local partners. You know, typically when we try and do something like this, we find people who really understand the community on a deep level. And that's what we've been able to put together here. You know, starting with somebody who we've had a you know, great relationship with building in this thing, in Charlie Levy that Mayor Stanton mentioned. You know, Charlie obviously is you know, an icon here in terms of the music scene in this city, and we couldn't be happier to have somebody who really understands the market and what talent is about in this market. So we're really fortunate to have him as a partner. Kurt Strawn back there, Kurt from Walter Productions. For any of you who don't know Walter Productions, you guys have a real treasure here in Phoenix. These guys are some of the most creative, innovative, experienced producers nationally. And you know, we've been working with them at Bonnaroo for the past 5, 6, 7 years, something like that. They've been an integral part of helping us keep that fresh and interesting. And to be able to be in their home market producing something alongside of them is a really special experience for us and our team. They're really going to provide a lot of the creative support and a lot of insight into the arts community and making sure we're accessing the right people to do this properly. Jared Dietrich over there, who some of you may know through the Phoenix Lights Festival. Jared is an amazing young entrepreneur who we really believe in and who we think is going to do a lot of great things in this city. He's really committed to being a part of this city and being entrepreneurial and creating new things. And we're excited to have somebody with that type of energy to help further this thing and make sure that we have our ears to the ground in every which way we can. And then we've got a couple national partners as well. One is Star Hill Presents. Star Hill is owned and run by a guy named Corin Capshaw, who's one of the most influential music managers and entrepreneurs in the entire music business and industry. He's somebody we've worked with both on Bonnaroo and Outside Lands. And so he's a real, it's a real opportunity for us to have somebody at that national level as a strategic partner for us. And Rehan Kadre, who's here as well, too. Where's Rehan? There's Rehan. And Rehan is part of a festival some of you may know in Las Vegas called Life is Beautiful. And, Rehan was a big part of the big catalyst in us coming here, really helped get us interested in coming to Phoenix, along with Jared and others. He's produced things in a market that has some similarities, some ideas that are going to be really transferable here. So we're really excited to have this, what we think is, an incredible partnership. And that's how these things get done well, is you get different ideas, you make sure that you're, really involved in the ground level. And that's what we're here to do, is really be additive to the community here, be a part of the community here, and hopefully create something that's really long-lasting and meaningful for the city of Phoenix and the region. So we have a short video to play for you guys. It's the teaser video that we're going to be announcing or putting up on our website and sending out today. You guys are really the first group to get a look at it. It's just a short little thing that we're going to show for just a minute. Talking about before is we really are feeling what's going on in Central Phoenix. I mean, it is palpable, the creativity that is emerging here, the development that's emerging here, the special cultural values that we think people hold here, and we think that's really ripe for this kind of community event that we're trying to create.
I just wanted to add, we would never call any part of the Valley of Sun the boonies. We prefer to use the term our suburban partners. How's that? Yeah.
So to answer that, I would say this is a gem in the heart, in the middle of Central Phoenix, an urban area where you have a gem of a location to be able to expose many people of what Phoenix has to offer. And just the being around the music, the entertainment, the restaurants, the art, it's all within this area, a walking area. If not, you can take transportation as a light rail to get to the different parts of the city. So
let me jump in on that because, as Vice Mayor just mentioned, light rail is critically important. Just as a few years ago when we hosted a million of our friends in downtown Phoenix, we couldn't have done that without light rail. Superfly wouldn't have even considered this particular location without the investment that the people of the city of Phoenix made in light rail, that ease of transportation. This is a great location right in the heart of the city, and it's easily accessible from any part of the valley, even the boonies, via light rail.
Rick, if you already said this, I apologize, but at what point did you start looking at Phoenix as a possible location?
It's been about a year and a half, 2 years, all in the process, somewhere in that neighborhood. Yeah. Go ahead.
So I'm assuming it's not going to be a camping festival.
Absolutely not.
So are you guys going to be partnering, if there's not really a place to camp, are you going to be partnering with local hotels to do special package deals or anything?
Yeah, we're working on a lot of those details. I mean, really what we want is people to come and stay in downtown Phoenix.
Yeah.
That's the focus for us because, you know, just like Mayor Saint was saying, the accessibility from downtown Phoenix is amazing. And, you know, we also want people to experience downtown. We're a little further, you know, north from there, but very connected. And so what we hope that this whole thing really does is contribute to the you know, evolution of downtown Phoenix, and it really becomes a part of it. So where people are staying, where people are eating before and after, maybe some of the entertainment that may happen, you know, as after parties or launch parties, things like that, really are going to be focused in that downtown area.
So I'm also hoping that they stay within Midtown and Uptown. And what I mean by that is we have on the Melrose Curve, we have a lot of entertainment areas and hotels. We have our local hotel, the Clarendon Hotel. There's many hotels around this area, but we're going to need all of them from downtown all the way up to Uptown. So I think we're going to be able to fill them all.
Yep. Well, you know, until we do it and study it, we can't say definitively, but what we can say is that the events that we do that are of the scale usually are in the tens of millions of dollars of economic impact.
Let me jump in on that, though. You know, on the culinary side of things, there'll be a whole new audience that'll be introduced to some of our talented chefs and locally owned restaurants, and they'll be returning customers over and over and over again. So there's obviously the immediate short-term economic benefit that Rick was talking about, but for the local bands that'll participate that now have a fan base that they didn't have before that's going to return for shows at Crescent Ballroom or wherever, and the local restaurants that'll participate and have the opportunity to offer their awesome food, and then people will become fans of that. Obviously there's a long-term economic benefit as well.
Yeah, and the way we look at it, you know, is, and you guys, as much as any city, have experienced the benefits of, you know, large-scale sporting events. You know, the Final Four is obviously here, Super Bowl, you know, those kind of things. Well, this is something we're going to be doing every year. So that impact is going to be continual. It's not going to be one, you know, year, and then we come back 3 or 4 years later like those things. This is going to be a continual impact.
Any idea about, any estimate at all, about what proportion of the people who will attend this might be coming in from out of town?
Well, I think we think that a very big portion will be local, but there'll be a portion that's probably more regional. You know, we're going to be marketing, you know, across the state and across the general Southwest region for sure. And then there'll be a certain component because of who we are, what our experience is, that will get national attention as well.
Do you have any sort of projected numbers as far as attendance?
No, not really for the first year, no.
I know it's,
I mean, the capacity here is pretty big.
You know, I don't think capacity here will exhaust in the first couple years. Our expectation is that this will build over time. You know, this is, you know, not going to be an Outside Lands or Bonnaroo tomorrow. Those things took time to build. This is going to take time to build. So, you know, we think we're going to have a strong but modest audience this year, and the plan is really for us to just produce that at a high level, have people leaving with a great experience, have the community feeling like it was a positive and something that is representative of what's going on here, and, you know, just build upon that.
But I would say what I really enjoy about this partnership is really the community piece. And really syncing the community together as we work with local talent and local artists, but also working with our high school, our Phoenix Union High School, and bridging those pieces together. Also making awareness of Indian Steele and the history. And so I think this is, for me, this is my first experience, but most of all, an awesome experience in the sense of just what we can imagine and envision and then build it together. So.
Would you be able to disclose the deal you guys have made? Is it going to be something similar like Bonnaroo, where you're paying a flat rate of $30,000 plus $3 per ticket, or how's that going to work?
The deal's different here, and yeah, I don't know if that's something we're releasing or we've made public in any way, but we feel really welcomed here. We feel like the opportunity to do what we're doing here is fantastic.
Do you have projected ticket costs yet?
Not yet. That'll be coming in a few weeks as we announce basically the next big announcement will be our artist announcement, which will have a lot more details, ticket information, and we'll be going on sale soon after we announce the artist info, and that will happen somewhere within the next month.
Just to ask a question, any involvement by the city will be disclosed and be transparent. I just don't have it right now, but we'll make sure we get it out to you. It's, you know, the city of Phoenix, our parks department is being so much more flexible for use of public spaces for exciting events that really build community. That's a change of culture within our city, very positive change of culture. But in terms of any specific commitments, in terms of resources of police or streets or parks, et cetera, that'll all be made public, of course.
What I really enjoyed about festivals like Outside Land, they really kind of embody the city that holds it. What more can you tell us about how a brand is accessible inherent to Phoenix, whether it's the names of the stages, things like that?
Yeah, sure. I think all of those elements that we've brought from other that we've experienced in other places that we've created, be very similar approach. What she's referencing is at Outside Lands, all of the stages are named for different neighborhoods. And you know, we've done a lot. I think a lot of the stuff that really binds people together is in that food and drink, the culinary space, the art space. We think the games is a really interesting one. So all of those things, we're going to be looking to have a uniquely Phoenix angle and branding to all of that stuff, for sure. All right. Well, thank you, everybody, so much for coming. We're totally accessible. If you have any other questions, feel free to approach me or our PR team. But we really appreciate your time, and it's been a pleasure to get to meet you all. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Rick.
Thank you.
Working with the city has been incredible. I mean, these things are tough to do, and you can't do them in a place that doesn't have cooperation, that isn't willing to work through problems and issues. And, you know, we've been very lucky. Mayor Stanton has embraced us and has really, you know, put a lot of energy into understanding exactly what we're trying to do here and helping us figure out how that's going to work. Vice Mayor and Councilwoman Pastor as well, you know, really supportive about using this amazing park and what we can offer to heighten the awareness of it in the community. You know, we've worked really closely with Deputy City Manager Paul Blue, who's been fantastic, really helping us figure out a lot of the logistics and particulars. And then also DPI and Dave Kreider have been, you know, a big catalyst to us coming here. They really understand the value of what an event like this can bring economically and bring in terms of you know, attitude and a cultural opportunity. And so it's really, you know, paramount to the reason that we're here.